Hi friends, welcome to biologyexamsforyou.com. Today we have an interesting topic from immunology. What do you mean by first line of defense and how first line of defense works within 5 to 10 minutes. If you are new to this channel, please consider subscribing our channel. Let's begin. What do you mean by first line of defense? First line of defense refers to the most basic innate form of non-specific defense mechanisms that prevents pathogen entry into the system or major organs of the body. It is manifested in three ways. There are physical barriers, chemical barriers, and biological barriers. It is comparable to a fortress wall that protects everything inside from the intruders or enemies. Just like this fortress wall, our first line of defense protects us by preventing the entry of disease-causing pathogens. First, let's have a quick summary. First line of defense involves physical barriers, chemical barriers, and biological barriers. The most important physical barrier is undoubtedly the skin. In the regions without skin, there will be some mechanisms like nasal hair, eyelashes, and eyelids in the case of eyes, mucous membranes, that is, all throughout the gastrointestinal tract, then mucociliary clearance, urination that flushes out microorganisms constantly. In the case of chemical barrier, most importantly, maintaining a low pH in areas having more chance of microbial growth, like skin with an acidic pH, then gastric acid, then vagina with a pH of 4.4, then there are many antimicrobial molecules, secretory IgA, sebum, mucus, lysozyme, lactoperoxidase, beta defensins, pepsin, and many more. And biological barrier that is formed by the normal microbial flora that protects us from all disease-causing pathogens. First, let's begin with physical barrier. The most important physical barrier is undoubtedly skin, the largest organ of the body. The major physical barrier, skin is having hair follicle that traps microorganisms. So this environment is acidic, so it is not suitable for microbial growth because it is having an acidic pH. So skin is a very tough, impenetrable, water-resistant layer. So let me make it more clear. So it is made up of epidermis and dermis. So this epidermis is made up of different types of cells. So corneocytes along with keratinocytes, which is primarily made of keratin protein, very tough, forming along with tight junction, forms a very tough layer preventing the entry of microorganisms to the inside. So there are dead cells also lining on the surface that is continuously replaced so that inhibiting the microbial growth on the surface. In the regions where there is no skin, like eyes, there are mechanisms like eyelashes and eyelids that protects the eyes from microorganisms and thus to reach this internal surface. The same is the case with nose. There are nasal hairs along with mucus that traps microorganisms and thus preventing the entry. Then throughout the gastrointestinal tract, that is from mouth to this anus, there is mucous membrane secreting mucus, then respiratory tract. In majority of the sites, there are cilia. So these cilia hair-like projections are called cilia, along that traps microorganisms. Along with mucus, it acts as a mucociliary clearance. That is one of the most important defense mechanisms once the pathogen gets inside through the openings. So this mucus, secreted by this mucous membrane, traps microorganisms. Cilia pushes out this mucus along with microorganisms to the outside, and which is often called as mucociliary escalator. That is, a healthy mucociliary escalator is very important for good lung health. So it will be expelled out either by means of coughing or sneezing, or it is moved down into the stomach where it is destroyed. So along with that, this physical barrier associated physiological responses are there, like coughing, sneezing, then diarrhea or vomiting, that forcefully expels out these microorganisms from the system. In short, it is very difficult to cross this barrier for microorganisms. That is why we are often getting some infections once we are having a wound, as pathogen entry is very easy once the layer of skin is broken. thus bypassing the most effective skin barrier, causing infection. Now moving into chemical barrier. The most important chemical barrier is maintaining low pH in crucial sites where the chance of microbial growth is very much, like skin with an acidic pH of 5.5, then gastric acid with a pH of 1 to 3, acidic pH, very acidic pH, almost kills all types of microorganisms. Then vagina with a pH of 4.4. Then there are many antimicrobial chemicals like secretory IgA, then lysozyme, then lactoperoxidase, which is a very important enzyme that causes killing of microbial cells that is present in saliva, tears, mucus, and colostrum, and many other secretions. This lysozyme causes breakage of bacterial cell wall. Secretory antibody can specifically neutralize bacterial toxins. Then in the case of skin, there is sebaceous gland that secretes sebum on the surface, which forms a protective biofilm that inhibits microbial growth, or that prevents microbial division and further spread of microbes. Then acidic pH is maintained at the surface also. This mucus secreted by mucous membrane that is present all throughout the internal linings of gastrointestinal tract, that is from mouth to this anus, there are mucous membranes that constantly secretes mucus that traps microorganisms along with cilia. It flushes out microorganisms from the body. Then beta defensins in epithelial cells, which is an antimicrobial protein that can cause lysis of these microorganisms by penetrating to the inside and causes lysis of the cells. These are efficient antimicrobial peptides. Then there is pepsin in gastric mucosal defense. Pepsin is a protease that cleaves antimicrobial peptides effectively inside the stomach. These are some of the chemical defense mechanisms. There are many that spreads throughout the system, protecting us effectively from entry of pathogen into the system. And finally, the biological barrier. Now we know that this is one of the most important barrier. Biological barrier includes the normal microorganisms on our body, the natural flora, microbial flora, that includes bacteria, virus, fungus, etc. Let's take an example. Take the case of skin. On the surface of skin, there are normal microorganisms that is growing, and these microorganisms form a microbiome barrier, secreting antimicrobial agents that prevents the growth of disease-causing pathogens on the surface of the skin. So this is a primary barrier. So they act like our soldiers, protecting us round the clock from disease-causing pathogens. Now many research suggests that this microbiome is very critical in normal functioning of our immune system. We are made up of more number of microorganisms than our cells. Are we controlled by these microorganisms? That is the major question. Anyway, this microbiome, this natural microbiome that is in association with our body, is very important and critical for our health. Some of the common species include Staphylococcus species, very common in skin, mouth, ear, etc. There are many species like Lactobacillus in urogenital sites that is living in harmony with our system, actually protecting us from disease-causing microorganisms. And that is about the first line of defense. If you like this video, please consider subscribing our channel. Thank you so much for your support. You are with biologyexamsforyou.com.